Hey guys, there's some big news today about colorectal cancer, the second leading cause of cancer death. In this video, I'm going to talk about who should get screened and what you can do to minimize your chances of getting it. And if you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm Dr. Mike Hansen, and I make these videos to provide accurate health information so you can stay in the know and truly better your life. So if you want to see more of these videos, I encourage you to hit that subscribe button and that bell notification. That way you don't miss out. Colon cancer, when caught early, is one of the most treatable and curable cancers. In the United States, about 52,000 people die of it every year, and that number is trending in the wrong direction. More and more younger people are getting it. As of right now, 10% of cases are in people younger than 50. Today, the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force just changed that recommended age to start screening for colon cancer from 50 to now 45. So the USPSTF joins the American Cancer Society in recommending screening for adults between the ages of 45 to 75. This is a recommendation for the general population, a whole separate category from those who are genetically determined to be at high risk of colon cancer. Those people will need screening at an earlier age or on a more urgent basis, and sometimes both. This also includes people who have a prior diagnosis of colorectal cancer or a history of colon or rectal polyps. The task force also recommends selective screening for those aged 76 to 85 to be made based on individual circumstances. So far, based on screening starting at age 50, for every 50,000 colon cancer deaths, 1,250 deaths are avoided. By dropping that to age 45, you're looking at avoiding 1,300 deaths. So going from age 50 to age 45 saves an additional 50 lives. Why are more and more younger people getting it? There are ongoing studies, and this is a huge topic. Although not yet proven, there's a lot of evidence that points to the Western diet. This means people who eat primarily processed food, especially processed meat, a lot of which contains nitrites. So nitrite consumption can lead to the formation of N-nitroso compounds, some of which are carcinogenic. But it's not just the processed meat. Processed food in general means low fiber and high amounts of added sugar. This is a recipe for chronic disaster and not just for the colon. And I'm going to come back to this in a bit. And just to be clear, nitrites are bad, nitrates are good. Nitrates are found in high amounts in beets. Your body changes nitrates into nitric oxide, which improves blood flow and can bring down blood pressure. For more info on this, you can check out a video I made right here. Colorectal cancer rates are far higher amongst Black Americans. They're 20% more likely to be diagnosed with colon cancer than white people, and 40% more likely to die from it. Is it because of diet? Is it genetics? Is it lower screening rates, access to care, all of the above? This is still an unknown with more research needed. In 2017, the U.S. Multi-Society Task Force on Colorectal Cancer recommended that screening begin at age 45 in African Americans and age 50 in other groups. Chadwick Boseman, the star of Black Panther, died of colon cancer at the age of 43. He was diagnosed at age 39, and that was back in 2016. At that time, it had already been stage 3, meaning it had already grown through the colon wall. The prognosis is so much better if you catch it at an earlier stage. His case highlights why it's so important to have these new guidelines, because we have to get ahead of this alarming trend. By the year 2030, colorectal cancer is actually on track to nearly double in people under the age of 50. And also by 2030, it's projected to be the leading cause of cancer-related deaths in ages 20 to 49. When it comes to colon cancer screening, is it better to do a colonoscopy or a stool test? It's important that you talk with your healthcare provider about which test is best for you. During a colonoscopy, a long, flexible tube with a tiny light and camera at the tip is inserted into your rectum. But hey, it's not as bad as it sounds, because most patients have little or no recollection of that experience, thanks to sedation. It's like they had no idea that Dr. Smith was in there looking at your entire colon and rectum, and looking for polyps, which in some cases lead to cancer. What did you find in there, Dr. Smith?
Not much. He's mostly full of shit.
Colonoscopy is the gold standard for colon cancer screening, and there are few risks associated with that procedure. But can you be screened without having to do a colonoscopy? A stool DNA test called Cologuard is an easy-to-use screening test that can be done at home. You collect a stool sample and send it off with your friendly mail carrier. And boom, you're done. The test is safe and poses no risk. But it is slightly less sensitive compared to colonoscopy, at least when it comes to finding precancerous polyps. About 1.5 people out of every 20 will have a false positive, meaning they'll have a positive result, but no cancer or polyps found when they eventually do that follow-up colonoscopy. Other factors that may increase your risk of colon cancer include conditions that cause inflammation in the colon, also family history of colon cancer, smoking, and a typical Western diet, especially with eating too much processed food and added sugar. While certain factors may be out of your control, like genetics, your family history, there are things that you can do to minimize your risk. This means eating real foods that are not processed. In other words, things like fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. These contain vitamins, minerals, fiber, antioxidants, and don't have that added sugar. For lots of people, it's hard to eat healthy because of taste, the time it takes to cook it, and money. When I don't have time to cook to get all those healthy nutrients I should be eating, my go-to is superfood powder, and then I just blend that in a glass of water or stir it in a glass of water. When it comes to alcohol, it's best to avoid it or at least keep it to a minimum. Nothing wrong with an occasional drink. And if you smoke, colon cancer is one more reason you can add to the list of reasons to quit. And of course, exercise and maintaining a healthy weight is very important as well. So that's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll be coming out with some new videos pretty soon. So stay tuned for that.